वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. सो लेट्स स्टार्टेड. वी नो दैट बाइंग एंड सेलिंग इज द फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट इन एनी ट्रांजेक्शन. इन आर डेली लाइफ वी डील विद दिस काइंड ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शंस वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू बाय समथिंग फ्रॉम द मार्केट एंड समटाइम वी आर द रिटेलर वी आर गोइंग टू सेल इट टू द कस्टमर. So the buying and selling, these are the very basic concept. So here, before understanding what is profit and what is loss, we need to get through some basic terms. So first of all, we are having CP, that is cost price. So the money which is paid by the purchaser to buy an article is called the cost price. So for example, if you are a customer and if you are purchasing anything from the market, so you are the purchaser and you are the customer, so you will give the money that for that thing. So that money is called as here a cost price. So cost price is what? The money which is paid by the purchaser to buy an article, or you can say the price at which the article is bought is called as what? Cost price. Next is what? Selling price. As the name itself suggests from the selling word, it is the price at which the article is sold to the customer. The shopkeeper is going to sell that article for the amount whatever is there. So the price at which the article is sold is called as a selling price. You can say SP, the price at which an article is sold. Now very basic and important thing we have to get here, finding profit and loss. In any transaction, it is very important to come to know that whether you have earned a profit or incurred a loss. That means we are going to get information about the two terms. First is a profit. So profit is here is a gain which you are going to earn. So for that a condition is required. If suppose you are having selling price and you are having a cost price. Selling price is the price at which article is sold, and the cost price is the price at which the article is bought. So if this selling price is greater than this cost price, that means you are going to earn a profit. So here you can see the definition. When the selling price is greater than the cost price, the difference between them is called profit. So most of the time shopkeepers are going to earn a profit, because whatever amount they are going to get through this selling, it is greater than the price at which they bought that articles in their shops. So suppose you can see here a shopkeeper is there who brought a pen for rupees 5, that is its cost price is 5, and when the customers are coming he is selling at a rupees 6. So here of course selling price is more, that means a shopkeeper earned here a profit, there is a profit of 1 rupee here. So you can say that when selling price is greater than the cost price, the difference between them is called profit. So your profit is earned. Now we are having loss. Again we are having two terms, that is cost price and selling price. Whenever the shopkeeper is purchasing the item from the retailer or a wholesaler, he is going to sell the customer at its more price. But sometime there is maybe some problems arises, there is a lot of stock is there, so he what do, he used to sell his price at a lower price as compared to the cost price. So in this case he is going to incur a loss. Why loss? Because here cost price is more and its selling is less. So when the selling price is less than the cost price, the difference is going to get is called as a loss. So loss incurred is CP minus SP, where CP is greater, the cost price is greater, and whatever the rate is there at which he is selling the article, it is less. So if the selling price of the article is less than its cost price, then the article, you can say, it is sold at a loss. And sometime the shopkeeper is not going to get a profit also and not going to get a loss, because in that case CP is equal to SP. So friends, you can say that no loss, no profit. And very important thing is there, profit and loss depends very much on the relationship between CP and SP. So you can say here, if CP is more, selling price is less, you can say it is a loss. And if CP is less than the selling price, you can say it is a profit. And if you want to calculate profit and loss percent, you can always going to calculate it on a cost price, CP. Let's see that percent. So here you are having profit and loss percent. Friends, you know that SP is more, SP is greater than CP, you can say that it is a profit, because it is a selling is more, selling price is more. So simply you have to difference, get the difference SP minus CP, you will get a profit. And if you want to calculate profit percent, if you want to calculate here profit percent, simply you have to write down profit upon CP, and then you will multiply it by 100 to get a percentage. So friends, in order to get a profit percent, you write down profit upon cost price. It is going to calculate on a cost price, and then you will multiply it by 100. So if suppose you are provided with the profit percent, if said that 10% is a profit percent, then you can easily get the selling price and you can easily get the cost price. Either of them should be needed, either selling price should be needed or either cost price should be needed. So we are having very simple basic formulas. SP is equal to 100 plus gain percent. Gain percent is here this one percentage, that is 10%. If it is 10%, you will add here 100 plus 10, that is 110 upon 100, and then you will write whatever CP is there. In the same way you can find out CP, you need to write 100 upon 100 plus gain percent multiply by SP. So if these formulas if you have learned, then you can easily calculate CP, SP, profit percent. Next we will see loss percent. So you know that when a CP is greater than SP, when the cost price is greater than its selling price, you have incurred a loss. So loss is just a difference, CP minus SP. And whenever you want to find out loss percent, you just need to write on loss, whatever the loss is there, upon CP, multiply by 100. Remember that loss percent and profit percent both are going to calculate over the CP. So if suppose loss percent is given, you can again get SP and CP. Yes, just you need to write down 100 minus loss percent upon 100, you need to multiply by CP. For example, if 10% loss is there, that means you need to find out 100 minus 10, that is 90. So 90 will be the selling price. And here we have calculated CP, that is as a 100 you can consider. So next, again, I would like to give you some points. For example, if suppose the gain, that is a profit percent, is given 20%. So remember here, I have considered CP as a 100. Always consider cost price as a 100. So here cost price is 100, and given that profit is 20%. So selling price I will calculate by adding 100 plus 20. That is 120. You need to get CP as a 100. Always remember, both the cases will consider cost price as a 100. If a profit percent given, add into it. If a loss percent given, subtract from it. So here simply profit percent given. So I have added into the 100, that means I get a 120. That was the selling price. And if suppose loss given, that is a 20%, then I'll minus it. Loss given, then I'll minus it. It will be get 100 minus 20, that is 80. So in the both cases, we have considered cost price is 100, not the selling price. Hope you have understood it. Thank you.